Good morning, students. Last video we have discussed smart card architecture, pin details, users, then details of smart card, details of a smart card reader, types, features, design process, advantages, disadvantages, and applications of smart card. Today we will see the next topic, that is automated teller machine. Automated teller machine, it is also called as ATM, or by its more formal name is asynchronous transfer mode, is a packet based network system designed for simultaneous transmission of voice, video and data. In the mid 1980s, the major telecommunication companies decided that they needed a new surge of video and data along with the voice traffic being sent over the existing network. From this, the concept of ATM was born, from an increasing need to handle data traffic, which is inherently packet based as well as voice traffic. ATM was designed to work as a packet switched network. ATM therefore is designed so that it can handle circuit switched traffic on its packet switched backbone. To accomplish this, ATM creates virtual circuit connection over the packet based network between the source and the destination. The definition of ATM machine is, it is a machine at a bank branch or other location which enables a customer to perform basic banking activities, that is checking one's balance, withdrawing or transferring fund even when the bank is closed. What is ATM card? It is a plastic card with a magnetic strip. It contains a unique card number and identify information. It is also known as cash card, bank card, client card, key card. This card issued by bank. Then see the diagram. Here this is the host processor. Host processor is the heart of the ATM machine. It contacts the bank server and retrieves your account details such as available balance, previous transaction, PIN details, etc. It verifies your PIN number, and if it matches with the provided PIN number from the bank server, you are allowed to make the transaction. To take your PIN and other requests from user, there will be a keypad or touchpad. So the next one is keypad or touchpad. Okay, so this is keypad or touchpad. Keypad or touchpad is responsible for taking input from the user. On this pad, numbers and few other keys such as a clear, okay, these keys are available. These keys are placed. Keypad transfers your inputted data to host controller to process the request. Then next one, speaker. Speaker is placed in ATM machine, which is responsible for audio alerts. When you press any key, the speaker confirms the pressing of key by producing a beep sound alert. It assures you that the keypad is working. So speaker is also very important part of ATM machine. The next one is a LCD or CRT screen. Another major integral part of the ATM machine is its cathode ray tube, that is a CRT, or a liquid crystal diode, that is a LCD screen. CRT or LCD screen is responsible for visual display of your transaction. It is responsible for displaying your name, entered amount, account number, etc. Without CRT or LCD display screen, the transaction from the ATM machine would have become more difficult. Then receipt printer is responsible for the printing of your transaction receipt. It will print whether the transaction is successful or not. It contains the important information in the form of fixed codes by which we can access the transaction status and its reason and the reason for failure. Receipt printer is a vital part of automated teller machine. The next one is cash dispenser. The most important part of the automated teller machine is cash dispenser. The cash dispenser is responsible for giving out the correct amount of cash you have requested for. After getting instruction from the host controller to pay the money, cash dispenser will count the money and dispenses the money out of it. So this is the function of cash dispenser. The next one, card reader. If there will be a no card reader, then ATM card cannot be read. So no transaction can be done by the machine. So ATM card is required to swipe through this card reader slot. After swiping card, it captures the account information through magnetic stripes of ATM. After retrieving the correct information of your account, card reader send the information to the host processor for further processor. Then how does the ATM works? ATM, that is a automated teller machine, is a computer. It has a small display and something similar to keyboard. If it does not look like one, it runs a program that is usually written by the bank. The program could do anything, but banks usually follow a pattern. Most banks start by asking for the language. You insert your card. This card has a magnetic strip on the back that it reads the information about your bank account. It uses this information to look up your account information and decide what to do next. Usually, this is true, have to enter your password. So after that, it's up to the program to decide what to do next. As for the equipment, banks usually buy the ATM as a single piece, but it is actually made up of components. There are several different computer types, but in PC, there would be several PC slots. In ATM card, you can access and carry out most of your personal banking transaction 24 hours, that is 365 days a year. With an ATM card, you can perform a wide range of transaction through automated teller machine at any time that is convenient to you, day or night. Then the features are deposit a cash or check in your account, then transfer fund between your own account, then check your balance, then change your PIN details, then view transaction history, then order statements or checkbooks, then send in other instruction to the bank via the mail deposit system, then make payment to others, same bank customers. Then ATM card also be used against your foreign currency account. So with this card you can withdraw cash from your account at a 50,000 maximum amount at 500,000 ATMs worldwide. That is a daily transaction limit depends upon your transaction, that is a bank account transaction. There is a daily cash withdrawal limit of BDT, that is a 20,000 or 50,000 for regular saving and a current account, and BDT 50,000 for a power vantage account. The minimum amount you can withdraw is a BDT 500 per transaction. So you can transfer up to BDT 1 lakh per day between account and bank flexibility. If suppose your card is lost, report if your ATM card is stolen or lost to the bank, or block the card immediately. What are the uses of ATM machines? Already I told uses of ATM machines. The first usage is making withdrawals, then making deposit, making payment, making fund transfer, then checking balances and updating account information. So these are the uses of ATM machine. In addition, some more points that related to ATM machines, that is security. All PIN encryption activity should take place on encrypting PIN code or PIN pad. Encryption device, that is a PIN encryption device, a PED, to prevent the compromise of a PIN in the clear at a terminal. ATM PIN encryption should be a triple DBS and DSS compliant. PIN blocks should never be stored in ATM log files. Personal account number, that is a PAN, should be truncated and protected in ATM logs. Secure remote access control must be established for all ATMs. Antivirus and malware detection system should be installed, updated and tested frequently. Insist upon a vendor's written result of each test. These are the advantages of an ATM machine. The first advantage is it is a very safety to use and carry. It's very safety because only user and bank can know its a PIN number. If a user lost his card, a hiker cannot hike his money. Anytime means 24 hours a day, that is 365 days a year, we can withdraw cash from your account. Use this ATM card, it can help us to waste our time. Ability to connect a LAN or WAN, L-A-N or W-A-N. Then disadvantages of ATM machine. ATM machine is very expensive, so it is not available in remote places. Cannot avoid illegal use in case of a stolen card. If you forgot our PIN number, we can't withdraw cash from our account. If we forget our PIN number and punch encryption number, then your card is logged. Then the next slide shows the applications of ATM. ATM are based on the personal computer embedded at the center of the machine. So the PC connect to multiple serial peripherals such as keypad, cameras, printers, cash dispenser, card reader, touch screen, etc. as required by the particular application. This serial connection is made via multi-part serial cards or adapter, which can provide up to 16 ports each. Low profile PCI board are particularly a good choice for this application because small size is the advantages to the often limited space available in the typical ATM. So far we have discussed ATM architecture, uses, then parts details, features, then advantages and disadvantages and applications of ATM machine. The remaining topic we will see in the next video. Thank you.